What's good, everybody? This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters. Want to tell you guys thank you so much for the support. And we'd like to ask you guys to hit the like button down below, subscribe to the channel, and just hit the bell notification up at top to get all notifications for future videos. Today, guys, we're going to be talking about simplifying expressions. So let's get started for today. So let's look at our first problem. In the first problem, we're going to have 9, and then in parentheses, we're going to have x minus 3. All right, we're going to close our parentheses, and then we're going to subtract, and then we're going to put in parentheses x plus 2. Now in this problem, what we have to realize is that we are going to distribute, but we're going to distribute more than one time. So after we distribute the first time, right, meaning we take that 9 and we're going to multiply it by x to get 9x, and then we're going to go back and multiply 9 by negative 3 to get negative 27. After we do that, we're going to go over to that second parentheses. But I noticed that there is no number in front of it. But we're supposed to distribute. So if you take a look, guys, this negative sign, that's what we're going to distribute to, x plus 2. And what happens is it acts like we're multiplying negative 1. So basically, we're going to be multiplying negative 1 by x to get negative x, and negative 1 by 2 to get negative 2. Basically, guys, we're going to be changing the signs. That's what that negative sign does. And after we distribute, we can now look back at this problem and combine our like terms. So let's start off with the x. So I got positive 9x and I got negative x, right? So once we add those two together, 9x plus a negative x, I know that's going to give me 8x, right? And then we're going to go back and we're going to combine negative 2 and negative 27. So if you guys remember, when we add numbers with the same sign, all we're going to do is add them together and keep it signed. So essentially, we're just adding 27 and 2 because they're both negative. So once we add that, we're going to get the answer of 29, and we know that it's negative. So now, oh, my bad, hit that a little too hard. We're going to put this together. Our final answer should be 8x minus 29. All right? Okay. So let's switch gears a little bit. We're going to go over now to order of operations and absolute value. So we're scrolling on down. And in this problem, this is what we're going to have. So let's write this down first. And then we could talk about what they're asking us to do. All right, so in this problem here, guys, what they're asking us to do, they want us to add negative 5 and 1, and then that answer we're going to divide by 2 and take it to the third power. And after we do all of that, we want to subtract 7. So how do we do this? So remember, guys, we're still working with order of operations, all right? So that means we have to start off with our parentheses. And if you guys remember, brackets also act as parentheses. So we're going to start on the innermost parentheses, and that's going to make us start with that 5 plus 1, negative 5, that is. All right, so once we do that, we're going to get negative 4. And that is the answer that we want to now divide by 2. Right? And we're going to rewrite the rest of the problem. And I took care of my absolute value. Just remember that absolute value, once it comes out the bracket, it becomes positive. But the problem still asks us to subtract the absolute value of 7. So that's why it's minus 7 at the end. Just a quick explanation. All right. So now we go ahead, we divide negative 4 by 2, and that's going to give us negative 2. And now we're going to take that answer to the third power. So quick reminder, remember, when it's an exponent, right, we're not going to do 2 times 3. Right? What we want to do is take that negative 2 and multiply it by itself 3 times. So that means negative 2 times negative 2, which is going to give us a positive 4, right? And after we have that positive 4, we're then going to multiply again by negative 2 to get negative 8. So now once we get negative 2 to the third power, we're going to bring down our minus 7. And guys, like we've said before, both of these numbers are negative. So once we add them together to get 15, we know that our final answer is negative 15. Wow. Coming together so good. All right. So let's just test it along one more time. Right? Third problem is always a charm. So in our last problem today, we're going to have 9 and then in parentheses 2 times k minus 4. We're going to close the parentheses and then we want to subtract 2 times 7k minus 12. Now, the first thing we want to identify, guys, is what number are we actually going to be distributing? So we know we're going to be distributing 9, right? So we're going to multiply 9 by 2k, and that's going to give us 18k, right? And then we're going to make sure we go back and multiply 9 by negative 4. That's not saying 9 minus 4. It's saying you're going to multiply 9 and negative 4, and that will give us negative 36. All right, so that's the first part of the distributing for this problem. Now when we go over to the second set of parentheses, I see that there is a 2 in front of it. Let's make sure that we pay attention to the sign, because that sign lets us know whether 2 is positive or negative. In this instance, it's going to be negative. So we're going to take a negative 2 and multiply it by positive 7k. When we do that, we'll get negative 14k. And then we want to make sure, like I said before, we go back and multiply by negative 2 by negative 12. When we distribute, we multiply that outside term by all the terms inside the parentheses. So let's just make sure we don't forget to multiply again, okay? So we're going to get positive 24. That's why we put our plus 24. All right, so after we distribute now, guys, I do see something familiar. I think they're called like terms, right? Yeah. So I noticed that 18 and 14 both have the same variable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to combine 18k, right, and negative 14k. So signs are the opposite. We're going to drop the sign, turn it into a subtraction problem. 18k minus 14k. That gives us 4k, right? When we look back at the original problem, our larger number, 18, was the positive number, so we know that this 4k is going to be positive. Now let's go back and do the same thing for, for negative 36. Wow, sorry about that, guys. My screen keep moving. We're going to do the same thing for negative 36 and positive 24. All right? So let's write it all out. Negative 36 plus 24. So we're doing the same thing as we just did with the 18k and the negative 14k. So I make these numbers both positive, and I change this into a subtraction problem. And when I normally do 36 minus 24, that gives me an answer of 12. Right? So now we're going back to the original problem, and I noticed that our larger number 36 is negative. So what does that mean for the answer? Yeah, that means that 12 is now going to be negative. So when we put the expression back together, it's going to be 4k minus 12.